Hello and welcome back. Let's learn how to use the TextBox change event to enter data quickly into an Excel worksheet. We will be always entering data of a specific length, like for example a mobile number, a roll number or an ID. So I fired up my Excel. I'm going to go to File and open the file and just watch what happens now. So when I open the file, it gives a message, Microsoft Excel security notice. So we'll say okay, enable macros. Our Excel worksheet opens, or our Excel workbook opens with the sheet 1 activated. In the range A1, you have the mobile number and a specific cell is selected. But you also get a message, please select the cell where you wish to start entering the data. So you click on OK, and then you can select the cell where you want to enter the data. I want to enter the data below the mobile number. Then I have here a button which helps me to open the user form for data entry. So I'll click here, a user form fires up, and there is a label at the top which says enter 10 digit mobile number. So as I said, this could be a roll number of a student or the ID of an employee, but we know that it has a specific length. So we will enter here the 10 digit mobile number, for example something like this. So you see, the moment I enter the last digit, the data will be entered into the Excel worksheet. There it is. Did you notice? The moment I enter the 10th digit, the data goes there. Once more. Last digit, and there the data has been entered. And at the same time, the text box is cleared. So I'm going to unload the form. Now, let us have a look at the complete coding. So this has been attached to a macro. We'll come to that in a bit. So we go to the developer tab, Visual Basic, and here I have the form with the label. As you can see, the name of the label is label 1. The caption is enter 10 digit mobile number, and the font, if you go down a little bit, you can see here is this one. And going to the ellipses here, you can change the different characteristics of the font, like the font size, the font style. Okay, then we have a text box here with the name TextBox 1. That's what we need. And we will right click on this to see its properties or view its code. Properties we have already seen, so we'll view the code. And you see here, first of all, at the top you see here in this object area that the text box 1 is selected, and in the procedure area you have change. Therefore you see private sub text box 1 underscore change. Here we write the code. If len of the text box, the length of the text box is 10, then enter the data into the active cell from the text box, and then activate a cell one row below that, clear the text box and end if, because we started with an if. So I've clicked on the Project Explorer, and let us have a look of the code in this workbook. So I'll right click on it and view code, and what you see here is that on the workbook open event, I gave out this message. Please select the cell where you wish to start entering the data. Now, let us have a look at the modules. So here, I will double click on the module 1. And you see, I've created a simple macro called Open User Form. And what it does is, it shows the user form, and this macro is assigned to this button. So if I click on it, you see, how do you assign it? You go to insert here, select the button form control, click and drag, and assign macro to the user form. Okay, so if I click here and I say okay, fine, and then I can change the caption. Open user form. Okay, let's go back to the Visual Basic from the developer tab, and here if you see, I'll just double click on this command button control. So I'll double click and you can see it just has this one line of code which says unload user form 1, which is close the user form 1. I hope you found this video interesting and useful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed as yet, consider subscribing. Thanks for watching.